Hey guys, Kristen Ostrander here from mommyincome.com, also from the Amazon Files, and this is your Amazon Files question of the week. We're going to talk about, is thrifting okay for Amazon? So we got this question. I can't remember the name of the person that sent it in now, so sorry about that. But the people want to know, is thrifting okay for Amazon? Can you sell used items on Amazon? Can you sell things that are used, or is thrifting okay? A lot of people get scared or nervous because they don't have this like proof of something. So number one, one of the things we want to warn you right away about when it comes to thrifting for Amazon. First of all, my answer is absolutely yes. It is perfectly okay to thrift on Amazon, and I want to tell you why. So number one is things like this. It's brand new, sealed in the package. I got this at an estate sale. I love estate sales. And so one of the things that I love to do is go to estate sales, garage sales, thrifting. I enjoy thrifting still. It's not the main part of my business, but I love it. So I love to do it, and I love to go there and do those things. So there's a couple of quick tips about selling thrifting for Amazon. Number one, you want to make sure that the very first thing that you look at, oh, by the way, we have the top 10 things that you can look for to thrift for Amazon. You need to go to mommyincome.com/thrifting. Thrifting, yeah, I can't even spell that, so don't even ask me to. mommyincome.com/thrifting to get our free download about the top 10 things to look for when thrifting for Amazon. I'm gonna give you three of them right here, and then the rest of them, you're gonna need to go download that PDF in order to get that. Great tips for thrifting for Amazon, and a couple of things to really, you know, they're kind of bolos, really. One of the things we definitely look for is anything brand new and sealed. Okay. So looking around from room to room, if you go to estate sales or in garage sales, gravitate towards anything that's brand new in the package. I don't care what it is, because half the time it's going to be worth some money. So make sure that you're looking for those types of things, anything brand new and sealed. Now, if you're at a thrift store, you need to be very careful that the thrift store itself doesn't reseal packages. I've had that happen before. I've been very burned on it. So making sure that you do look for that. So the top 10 things to look for when thrifting on Amazon, mommyincome.com/thrifting. You're going to want to get that whole thing. I'm going to give you three. Number one is anything brand new and sealed. And of course, this is from an estate sale. So I'm pretty sure the estate sale people are not in the back room using stretch film and, you know, shrink wrap to shrink wrap, stuff like that. So these are, you know, I got a whole stack of these from this yard sale or from an estate sale. They're brand new, sealed, the great courses, DVDs, and book sets. Love this kind of stuff. Same thing with CDs, DVDs. Make sure that you're approved in whatever category it is, or else you're going to get burned. But this is a reggae DVD or CD set, never been opened. Sells for like $50 on Amazon. This was $3. People think CDs are obsolete. Not a chance. The other thing that we love looking for, both new and used, is board games. Children's board games, old school board games, new school board games, and both new and used. This little gem right here, this horseplay card set, is from Breyer. This is like a little kid's board game type of thing. This is actually opened. It's not new and sealed, but is in mint condition. And my daughter took the horse out of it already. She was playing with it. I'm like, that's for sale. Stop it. So this is something that's used. This sells for $59.99 used on Amazon. So I'm totally selling this. And it's like new, but it's used. If it's in the toy category, they make you say it's collectible, but whatever. Used board games do really well. But also, so do brand new ones. This one's new and sealed. And this is a nice another $50 gem that we have. It was 20% off that day. Paid about $8 for this. I'll make about $50. So those are the first things you want to look for, the top three. Number one is going to be anything brand new and sealed in any category. If it has new with tags, brand new, unopened boxes. Number two is going to be used board games. Guys, count the pieces. Like literally open the board game, look at the pieces, and count them. There's no greater way to waste your money, even if it's a dollar. If you go to a yard sale or a thrift store or something like that, and you buy a dollar or $2 board game, and then you don't actually make sure the pieces are all there, ask me how I know. So, you know, I've learned from that, but used board games do really well. And the other thing that I would suggest using would be suggest looking for are accessories to things like kitchen appliances. So that's one of the things that's on the list is like KitchenAid mixers. They sell the little paddles and the little whisks and different parts, the pasta maker, the attachments. You can sell the attachments as used on Amazon. They don't have to have boxes, and they're heavy duty, high quality, and they can make you a lot of money. Look at these things from yard sales and thrift stores and things like that. These are other often things people overlook that you can still sell used on Amazon. You're not going to get can't guarantee that, but you definitely don't get inauthentic claims for used KitchenAid mixer parts. Inauthentic claims are something people worry about when they do thrifting for Amazon, and I'm just here to tell you that if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. If you're trying to buy a Coach bag or, a Fendi something, or, you've got a pair of Prada shoes, whatever it is, like if you can't authenticate that something is real, then sell it on eBay or sell it on Poshmark or something else, but save your good stuff for Amazon. You don't want to sell used things like that on Amazon or high-end brands where you can't prove the authenticity of something. But no one's going to worry about the authenticity of my board game that I'm thrifting. So just making sure that you're paying attention to that. So the answer to your question of the week for the Amazon files is yes, you can thrift for Amazon. Go to mommyincome.com/thrifting and get your free download of our top things, Amy and I's top things we look for when thrifting for Amazon. So I hope this helps you. Go get your download, and by all means, start thrifting. This is like almost $500 of product here for less than 20 bucks. So why not? Make sure you make that money and go do that. So thanks, friends, for joining us. See you next week on the question of the week. And also, if you want to submit your questions of the week so that Amy and I can answer them, submit that to admin@mommyincome.com and make sure you use the hashtag question of the week so that we know that this is your question that you want answered live. And we'd love to help you out. Like, share, tell your friends. We are the place to learn about Amazon. If you want to register for our free show, every Monday night we do a show and we talk all things Amazon, the Amazon files, www.theazfiles.com to register. We're talking about mistakes you're making on Amazon. We have some really cool upcoming shows, so you want to register for that. Love you guys. See you next time.